Very good morning, my dear students. I welcome you all for VTU eShikshana program. This is 10th session on thermal radiation of heat transfer subject. Myself, Dr. Madhukeshwarayan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering Department, Jain Institute of Technology, Davanagere. So today also we will do some of the problems to understand the concepts of thermal radiation. So the examples are as follows. Now this is the one of the typical example. I'll read it now. The energy received by a 2 meter into 2 meter solar collector whose normal is inclined at 45 degree to the sun. The energy loss through the atmosphere is 50% and the diffuse radiation is 20% of direct radiation. Given that the surface temperature of sun is 6000 Kelvin, distance between earth and sun is 12 into 10 to the power of 10 meter, diameter of the sun is 1.5 into 10 to the power of 9 meter, diameter of the earth is 13.2 into 10 to the power of 6 meter. Calculate energy emitted by the sun, solar radiation received per meter square area outside the earth atmosphere, energy received by the earth and energy received by a 2 meter into 2 meter solar collector. So here what they have given, so the area of the collector is given and the collector makes an angle of 45 degree with the sun rays, or the sun rays makes an angle of 45 degree with the normal to the collector. Loss through the atmosphere is 50% due to the, and diffuse radiation is 20% of direct radiation, and sun surface temperature is given, diameter of the sun is given, diameter of the earth is given, and distance between the earth and sun is given. We have to calculate solar radiation received per meter square outside the earth's atmosphere, means in the extraterrestrial space outside the earth's atmosphere, what is the radiation we are receiving, that we have to calculate. So when we calculate outside the earth's atmosphere, we should not take into the account of atmospheric losses and the diffuse radiation losses. And energy received by earth is earth surface. The second one, what is the total amount of energy received by the earth, we have to calculate. Energy received by 2 meter into 2 meter solar collector, that also we have to calculate. So at the earth surface, if we place a collector of 2 meter into 2 meter, that is 2 into 2, 4 meter square of solar collector, how much it will receive the radiation, that also we have to calculate. Now in order to solve this problem, we will continue like this. So the data given is like this. Surface temperature of the sun is 6000 Kelvin. So the radius, that is nothing but distance between sun and earth, is taken as R, 12 into 10 to the power of 10 meter. Diameter of the sun, 1.5 into 10 to the power of 9 meter. Diameter of the earth is 13.2 into 10 to the power of 6 meter. Now the collector surface area is taken as AC, which is equal to 2 into 2 meter square, and theta angle between sun rays and normal to the collector is 45 degrees. With this, now we can calculate the first one, that is energy emitted by sun, that is taken as E suffix B, as EB is equal to sigma into T to the power of 4, nothing but 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into 6000 to the power of 4. Which is equal to 73.4 into 10 to the power of 6 watt per meter square. So this is nothing but energy emitted by the sun, or we have considered sun as a black body and energy emitted by the sun. Now area is equal to area of the sun can be calculated as A1, which is equal to 4 pi r square. This is the area of the sphere. Now 4 into pi into 1.5 into 10 to the power of 9 square divided by 2. Which is equal to 7 into 10 to the power of minus 8 meter square. That is the area of the sun. Next, energy emitted by the sun is EB is equal to 73.4 into 10 to the power of 6 multiplied by 7 into 10 to the power of 18. That is nothing but 5.14 into 10 to the power of 26 watts of energy emitted from the sun surface. Now the second one is the emission received per meter square just outside the Earth's atmosphere. So this is nothing but to calculate R is 12 into 10 to the power of 10 meter, that is distance between sun and earth, A is equal to 4 pi r square that is 4 into pi into 12 into 10 to the power of 10 square. Which is nothing but A is equal to 1.80 into 10 to the power of 23 meter square. The radiation received outside the Earth atmosphere is calculated using above values, that is per meter square, which is equal to 1/A, that is energy emitted by the black body or sun, 5.14 into 10 to the power of 26 divided by area, 1.80 into 10 to the power of 23, that is 2855 watt per meter square. Energy received by Earth is equal to 2855.5 into Earth's area. Now 2855.5 into Earth area is pi d square by 4. That is taken as area, projected area, that is circle. So diameter of the Earth is taken, and which is equal to 2855.5 into pi by 4 into 13.6 into 10 to the power of 6 square, which is equal to 3.88 into 10 to the power of 17 watts. And the next one is fourth one. So energy received by 2 meter into 2 meter, that is 4 meter square collector at the Earth surface. For that we need to calculate first energy loss through atmosphere that is equal to 50% of energy, that is nothing but energy received or reaching Earth is also 50% from the sun's rays, that is 0.50 into 2855.5, which is equal to 1420 27.7 watt per meter square. Diffuse radiation is 20%, that is 0.20 into 1427.7 is equal to 285.5 watt per meter square. the total radiation reaching the collector is 1427.7 plus 285.5 watt per meter square, which is nothing but 1713 watt per meter square. Now plate area is equal to A cos theta, which is equal to 2 into 2 cos 45. Which is 2.82 meter square. So energy received by the collector is equal to 2.82 meter square into 1713.2 watt per meter square, which is 4831.2 watts. So this is the amount of energy received on the collector at the earth atmosphere. So now we will take one more problem. So the next example is like this. So the next problem is, calculate the net radiant heat energy exchange per meter square area of two large parallel planes at a temperature of 427 degrees Celsius and 27 degrees Celsius respectively. Epsilon for hot plane is 0.9 and epsilon for cold plane is 0.6. If a polished aluminium shield is placed between them, find the percentage reduction in heat transfer. That is, epsilon shield is equal to 0.04. So you can see that there are two large parallel planes are there. Both are at a different temperature, 427 and 27. Epsilon, that is emissivity for both, are different, 0.9 and 0.6. And if we place a polished aluminium in between them, which is having emissivity 0.04, what is the percentage reduction in the heat transfer, that we have to find out. For that, so first we will write the schematic of the given problem. Now you can see, I'll write the plates and the shield. T1, T2, T3 are the temperatures. T1 and T3 are the plates. Epsilon 1 and epsilon 2, epsilon 3 are the emissivities. In the absence of the shield, the heat flow between the plates one and three is given by Q1 to 3 is equal to sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1, which is equal to 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into 700 to the power of 4 minus 300 to the power of 4. This whole divided by 1 divided by 0.9 plus 1 divided by 0.6 minus 1. Which is equal to 5.67 into 2320 divided by 1.78. Which is equal to 7390 watts. This is the first answer. Heat transfer between the sheets. Second one. When the shield is placed, we have to calculate, that is, when shield is placed, between plates 1 and 3, plates 1 and 3, then Q1 to 2 is equal to Q2 to 3, which is nothing but sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1 is equal to sigma into T2 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4 divided by, T3 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 2 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1. That is, we can cancel sigma on both the sides. 700 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 is equal to T2 to the power of 4 minus 300 to the power of 4. Divided by 1 divided by 0.9 plus 1 divided by 0.04 minus 1 is equal to, on that side, divided by 1 divided by 0.04 plus 1 divided by 0.6 minus 1. So 0.9 is the value of epsilon 1, epsilon 2 0.04, epsilon 3 is 0.6. So T1 700, T2 unknown, and T3 300 Kelvin. Now on simplifying, we get T2 is equal to 595 Kelvin. And Q1 to 2 is equal to sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1, which is equal to 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into 700 to the power of 4 minus 595 to the power of 4 divided by 25.11. That is 5.67 into 2401 minus 1253 divided by 25.11, which is equal to 2118 watts. So this is the second answer, heat transfer with shield. Next we need to find out reduction. Therefore, reduction in heat flow due to shield is Q13 minus Q12, which is nothing but 7390 minus 2118. Which is equal to 5272 watts. And the last one is percentage of reduction in heat transfer is equal to 5272 divided by, that is heat transfer with shield divided by heat transfer without shield, 7390 into 100 is equal to 71.34. So this shows that by providing a radiation shield, heat transfer reduces by means of 71.34%. Now we will take one more problem. So the problem is like this. Determine the number of shields required to keep temperature of outside surface of hollow brick lining of furnace at 100 degrees Celsius when the temperature of the inside surface of the lining is 500 degrees Celsius. Take the emissivity of brick lining as well as for shield is 0.87. heat transfer to the surrounding from the outer surface takes place by radiation and convection. The heat transfer coefficient for natural convection is given by HA is equal to 1.44 into delta T to the power of 0.33 watt per meter square Kelvin. TA is equal to air temperature 25 degrees Celsius. Neglect the heat transfer by conduction and convection between brake lining. So this is what they have given the problem. We have to calculate number of sheets required to keep the temperature outside surface of a hollow brick lining of furnace 100 degrees Celsius. So how many number of sheets that we have to calculate? Emissivity is given as 0.87. HA is given as 1.44 into delta T to the power of 0.33. Air temperature is given as 25 degrees. Now let us solve this problem. Now the solution for this one is, for steady flow or steady state condition, the heat lost by inner lining through shields inner lining through shields to the outer lining is equal to heat lost by the outer lining to the surroundings. Heat lost by the outer lining to the surroundings. Which is equal to QC plus QR, where QC and QR are heat lost by outer lining to the surroundings by convection and radiation respectively. Now let me draw the schematic of the problem. So I have drawn left side the continuous line, that is inner lining, right side outer lining, in between some n number of sheets. Inner lining is at 500 degree Celsius. Outer lining is at 100 degree Celsius. Now in between dotted lines represents n number of sheets. QC can be calculated as QC is equal to A into HA into T naught minus TA. Where HA is equal to 1.44 into delta T, that is 1.44 into 100 minus 25, that is delta T to the power of 0.33, that is 100 minus 25 to the power of 0.33, which is equal to 1.44 into 4.16. Which is nothing but 5.99 watt per meter square Kelvin. Now QC can be calculated by substituting this value of HA, that is area is taken as 1 meter square into 5.99 into 100 minus 25, where A is equal to 1 meter square which is equal to 5.99 into 75. Which is nothing but 449.25 watts. QR is equal to A into sigma into epsilon, into T naught to the power of 4 minus TA to the power of 4. Which is equal to 1 into 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into 373 to the power of 4, that is T naught, minus 298 to the power of 4, which is 5.67 into 0.87 into 193.6 minus 78.9, which is nothing but 565.8 watts. Therefore, QT is total heat transfer 449.25 plus 565.8. Which is 1055 watts. This is the amount of heat radiated from inner surface to outer surface. Through n number of sheets, we have to determine number of sheets when these are n sheets, the surface resistance are 2n plus 2 and space resistance are n plus 1 The space resistance for parallel plates is equal to one divided by F1 to 2 is equal to one divided by F2 to 3 is equal to one divided by F n minus 1 whole minus 1 minus n, but F1 to 2 is equal to F2 to 3 is equal to Fn minus 1 minus n is equal to 1. Therefore, total space resistance RS is given as RS is equal to n plus 1 into 1 divided by F1 to 2 is equal to n plus 1. Total surface resistances R surface is equal to 2 into n plus 1 into 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by epsilon 1, as epsilon 1 is equal to epsilon 2 is equal to up to epsilon n. Where 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by epsilon 1 is radiation surface resistance, between two parallel surfaces each of 1 meter square therefore our surface is equal to two into n plus one into 1 minus 0.87 divided by 0.81 is equal to 0.15 into n plus one. Now QT is equal to sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by RS plus R surface. Which is equal to 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8. Into 773 to the power of 4 minus 373 to the power of 4 divided by n plus 1 plus 0.15 into n plus 1, which is equal to 1.55 into, sorry, is equal to 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into 773 to the power of 4 minus 373 to the power of 4 divided by 1.15 into n plus 1, where n plus 1 is equal to 15.78. Or n is equal to 14.78, that is 15.78 minus 1, so rounded as 15. So 15 number of shields are required between two parallel surfaces. So this is the solution for this problem. With this I will conclude all my sessions on thermal radiation chapter. I thank Vice Chancellor Vishveshwaraya Technological University, Registrar Academic and VTU eShikshana Coordinators, also Faculty Advisory Board of Vishveshwaraya Technological University for selecting me as one of the course expert to teach this chapter online under VTU eShikshana program. Also, I thank management of my institute, that is Jain Group of Institutions, for supporting me to take this assignment and helping me to complete. So I thank one and all who have helped me directly or indirectly to teach this subject online under VTU eShikshana program. So you can note down my email ID and phone numbers and contact me for any clarifications on any of the sessions of thermal radiation. Once again, thank you very much. Thank you all.